I was you need to tell the story. This is the funniest story Caitlyn told me.
He came to
him here a couple of years ago.
He came to me and he's like, babe, I'm going to this brokerage. Look at this guy's beard. And I'm like, what? That's not a reasonable, like, what does he offer to you? What is it like? What is he doing? He's like, no. It's all about the beard. And I'm like, oh, God. This is going to go horribly wrong. And then he came for the interview and he came back to me with like what you guys would offer and how it was going to be better for us and like his business. And I was like, okay, so it's him coming here has been, even though it's based on AZ's beard, has been the best thing that's ever happened.
What is going on? Welcome to another great episode of Women in Real Estate, powered by Badass Agents, where we talk about real life with real women that face all these many challenges. I am excited to introduce my guest today. Last week, or a couple of weeks ago, we had Craig Morton, one of our top producing agents here at AZ & Associates. We heard from him a couple of weeks ago on one of the podcasts, Women in Real Estate, on his perspective on women in business. So today, I have his lovely spouse, Caitlyn.
Hi.
What is going on, Caitlyn? So before we get to our subject, you know, spouses and real estate, being married to a realtor, we either make you or break you. So I want to talk to you, Caitlyn, about my story. First, I'm going to tell you about my story.
Okay.
And then I want you to kind of see if you can relate to this, because I know you just had a baby.
Mm-hmm.
So I remember years ago when we first started in this real estate game, I was in the hospital with contractions. And I remember we were in the car in AZ. Let me start from the beginning. I was working from home at the time, and I was working, obviously, in real estate. So I knew that I was having contractions and I was about to have a baby. So I was just like, okay, I'm going to wait a couple of more minutes until my contractions get a little closer. Let me finish the last minute phone calls and that I need to do with contractors and get all my stuff ready. So I did. And I, within 10, 15 minutes, my contractions got really hard. So I gathered all my things together, including my laptop, all my paperwork, put them in my briefcase and actually my backpack and maybe a change of clothes. So I was like, all right, I'm ready to go. So I finally called AZ. I'm like, hey, you need to come get me. I think I'm having the baby. He's like, all right, give me about a couple of minutes and I'll be there, because he was down the street at the office. So he shows up, and on the way to the hospital, the guy is making a couple of deals. He is calling his clients as his wife's next to him, and I'm like, I'm getting married. So we show up to the hospital, and I'm under immense stress. And the doctor's like, she is extremely stressed out. What was she doing before she got here? And obviously he couldn't answer. And I was like, I was working. So they put me in a room and they had to bring my stress down because it was really, really extremely high. But during this time, I remember going through all this pain, obviously, and AZ was on the phone the whole time. And I'm looking at him like, hang up the freaking phone, dude. I am about to get burned. You're making deals happen. But at the end, I was just as much at fault as he was, because in my backpack, I had my laptop and all my paperwork, because I knew I was going to stay there for a couple of days. So I was just like, I might as well gather all my work that I'm going to do while I'm in the hospital. And well, he did the same. But real estate can make you extremely emotional. It can have you all over the place. And a couple of things about AZ and I is, when we had bad months and good months in real estate, when our business was up and down, we stayed consistent. We stayed consistent in our systems and processes. We stayed consistent in our marketing. We stayed consistent in our staff. We stayed consistent in everything to run a successful business. But what wasn't consistent was our marriage. Our marriage was up and down based on months, based on weeks, based on days, shit, based on hours. It really depends on what we had. We were business partners. And it was really extremely tough when we first started real estate, just because, like I said, our relationship was not consistent. Everything else was, except our relationship. So Caitlyn, talk to me, sister. Did you ever feel this? And I want to say Caitlyn here is a nurse.
Yep.
She's actually not a real estate, but she's married to one of our top producers, Craig Morton. So I want to hear your perspective. We heard Craig's, and if you have missed Craig, you can catch him on our website, I believe, and he's also on YouTube and on some of those sites, AZ & Associates. So we have him out there so you can listen to his story. But now I'm wanting to hear from his lovely spouse. How did you see yourself? How did you play that role in real estate with Craig Morton?
So when he first started, I was just starting nursing as well. So it was kind of, we were both transitioning our careers. So we were definitely had more of a friendship than a marriage or even a relationship because we weren't married then. But as it went on, I became steady in my job because I went and worked for a big company and it just kind of clicks right away and you don't have to start your own stuff. So it was kind of.
What were the, I know that when, so you weren't married when he started his real estate career. Mm-mm. You weren't, you were in a relationship. You were engaged. How did you see that? Was it tough? I mean, did you see him at all? Was it?
It was, you know, not until he started like really investing everything into it did it get like super tough. At first it was kind of, he was learning the way, he didn't know what he was going to do, so he kind of still had boundaries. More successful he wanted to be, he started losing all his boundaries and giving himself to everybody.
And how did you see that? How did that affect you?
It was definitely hard because I'm like, well, what about me?
Right.
I went a day of like no phone calls, no emails, nothing, so it took a lot of evolving.
Did you see those days?
Oh yeah, we had, I think our whole first year of marriage was like, we didn't like each other.
Yeah, but you stuck
but
it through.
But we loved each other enough to stick through it because it was fighting through to see what was more important.
Right.
And fighting to see, like, is it really worth what you're doing? Is it going to be worth it in the end? So,
right.
And it is. It's been definitely worth it.
Now, I know when you're, I've heard this before in the industry where a lot of people see from the outside in, a lot of realtors and business owners in real estate, entrepreneurs, that, you know, our investors and so on and so forth, they think we have a lot of money and have a lot of time. Mm-hmm. And that's far from the truth. You know, they don't see the ups and downs in the relationships, not just with their spouses, but with their family members, even with their kids at times. We don't see them. We're constantly out. You know, the most important thing is our clientele, right? Well, that's the way we need to see it at the beginning of a business, obviously, because if we want to see our business successful and flourish, we have to understand other areas are going to suffer.
Yeah.
And the first thing that suffers is those loved ones around us. And it, like I said, it can be the marriage, it can be the kids, it can be anybody that we love so deeply that it says we don't have enough time for you anymore because we need to grow our business. So it can get really extremely ugly. But marriage, it just, it tends to, like, marriage, it, in real estate, it's like it's either going to make a realtor or it's going to break it. Mm-hmm. So a lot of divorce and separation happens in real estate because of that, because they don't understand the other side of, hey, my spouse is now an agent and is constantly having to pick up the phones and immediately answer to these emails. Yeah. And I get it, after a couple of years, you kind of learn the game. You start to hire staff and people are answering your emails and everything's different. So you have a little bit more balance and more time for your family. But when you first start up, you don't see the face of your spouse.
Yeah.
And a lot of people don't understand that. That is actually the hardest thing to understand if you have a spouse that has a career but is managed through company hours.
Yep.
Not running, you know, company hours is different than running your own business as an entrepreneur because you're constantly on the phone. There is no deadline and there is no time where you're like, okay, I'm not going to pick my phone up after 8 o'clock because that one random number that comes in at 9 p.m., you don't know, it could be a potential client. It could be right there, you know. So as that agent, you don't want to miss that sale. You don't want to miss that potential buyer, the you know, client or whatever. But on the other end, it's like, why are you picking up your phone at 9? It's like, I'm just starting my business. And a business doesn't pick up for us. It was, man, it was what, a couple of years in.
Yeah.
So AZ and I've said this before, where him and I had a great relationship in business. We were business partners way before we were husband and wife because it's just, we didn't see that, you know, the spouse romance and any of that, you know, date nights or any of that, just because there was not enough time. So how tough was that for you on your end when that time went by and you were like, is this a life that I want to live?
Yeah.
If you saw that Craig, because Craig didn't have anything. He had no systems and processes, no help, nothing, right?
Nothing.
Did you see yourself running at his pace of understanding that you might not see him as much? How did you take that on?
Well, it was kind of, because I was just starting nursing and I was very driven and still very driven, but I was doing my own thing and it would be like, I worked my 3 days and it didn't even bother me. And then like, as he got more busy and I was having my stuff slow down and I got to where I wanted to be, I got to be a charge nurse, it started to really hit me. It's like, okay, I'm where I want to be. Why are you still
where you're at?
Why are you still taking up all this time and not going anywhere? Which I had to slow down and look at him and be like, okay, you are going places. It's just a slower development.
Right.
You can't just climb the corporate ladder. You got to build all these stuff.
You know, and something about you, Caitlyn, that I completely admire, and I wanted to bring you on here because you're not only just a nurse. you are multiple things. You play many, many roles, and I admire you so in so many ways. You're such a powerful woman to me. One, you're a nurse. You're also a spouse of realtor. So you have to put up with a
Frank.
Oh, yeah. And now a full-time mommy. But in this time that you were actually pregnant, and your pregnancy was not a really good one, right? You had a lot of trouble in that pregnancy. And I want to hear a little bit about that. You were also in the transition of now you are a business owner. You opened up your own boutique. So how did you manage? And I think a lot of women need to hear this. You're not just a nurse, you know, being assistant to other people. But oh, my gosh, you became now a business owner of a boutique. And you're just a I mean, your baby's not even a month, right? It's a month and a half.
8 months, 8 weeks.
Eight weeks. Wow. So, I mean, you're literally that package. I mean, it's insane. Talk to me a little about that. How has that been for you?
Well, the pregnancy was really hard, and that's why we're one and done. One kid and done, because I'm a goer. I like to do things, and it just took everything out of me. And then I had him 6 weeks early, so it was scary then, because you didn't know if he was going to go to NICU, if he had issues. But now that all that part's over. But, you know, before I had him, I was transitioning to, like, what am I going to do long term? Mm-hmm. So why not start when I have the chance? I get 3 months off through my work when I have my kid. Mm-hmm. So why not use that time to spend time with my kid, figure out what I want to do? And in the first, like, 3 weeks of after I had him, the opportunity, like, knocked on my door and was like, all right, it's go time. You're going to need to open your med spa.
And by opportunity, you didn't think twice. You literally just took it on.
Yeah.
You like didn't even doubt or what went through your mind of knowing you had a newborn.
Yeah.
You don't have, and I'm not trying to say Craig's not helpful. I'm sure he's a wonderful father. But what I'm saying is you knew Craig wasn't going to go all in. He had his own business running, right? He's his own business owner. Yeah. You're your own business owner. Where did you think all this was going to land into? Like, who's going to take care of the baby? Where is all this? You know, you're nursing. You still have the nursing. That's very much important to you.
Yeah.
So how did you think you were going to handle all this? Like, what went through your mind?
You know, I don't think I've slowed down enough to really think it through.
I love that. I love that so much. I was hoping for that answer. When people are always like, why, how are you so busy? How do you handle so much, Carla? I'm like, I don't know. I don't stop to process that part. I just keep going. I think it's just, as long as you're having fun and continue challenging yourself, you just want more.
Yeah.
Right? More.
And it's not, I mean, it's stressful. It's been stressful starting and getting everything set up for the med spa, but it's totally been worth it this last week because it's finally all in place and I can do what I want to do and love it. And it's flexible to where I can take Rex with me. I can leave him with my mom or him.
And again, no one sees that in between.
Yeah.
It's easy to say, I can take him. I can do this. And it's, you know, I'm my own business owner now, my own hours, but no one sees that in between. And that's what I was going to ask you. You want more in business. Mm-hmm. When you saw yourself like, I want more. I don't just want to be a nurse. I want more. I want to be a mom. I want more. Okay, now I want to be a business owner. I want more. And I'm sure you're not going to stop there. Knowing Caitlyn, the way I've known Caitlyn, she's not going to stop there. I'm sure ideas are running through your head and you're going to go full blown on all this in your boutique and everything. But what do you see your marriage looking like now? Like, where do you see it now? I know it's obviously, it's a healthy marriage. I know you guys love each other. Mm-hmm. But as the challenges that you might face, you know, it's not necessarily as a negative. It's, you know, you're not going to go in there skipping. I'm just the challenges that you think you might face knowing what's going on today.
So I don't know. It's hard to think about challenges because we've kind of been through that. Then we've gone to where we respect in each other's time and drive and everything. So now it's a little bit easier that the challenges are not as obvious. So I think just challenges of building my business and putting that time in and listening to him and seeing what he has to say because he has marketed. And even though I do have a marketing degree too, I haven't used it in years because I've been nursing. So it's hard to like accept things from him. I think is the biggest challenge. Like
that's what I'm wanting right there. Those are one of the challenges because you and I love this part because you've been there's always new challenges coming up in our relationship, right? And I love that you're like I don't know about the challenges that we used to have in the past because we already went through those. So we know we're gonna handle them now, right?
Yeah.
They come up. These new challenges are now. that Craig is his own business owner. He's been in the marketing field. He's been in the sales department, all that kind of good stuff. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's very successful at it. He's obviously one of our top producing agents. He's phenomenal at what he does. Now it's time for, okay, Caitlyn, you got to put on your student hat. And you're just like, I got to sit there and be a student.
Yeah.
As my husband teaches me all these things that I haven't been in the game. So because now you're a business owner with your mm-hmm. own boutique. So now you have to go that route. That had to be the hardest part for me.
Yeah.
I'm very
sucking that one up.
Yes. And I want to talk about that because I'm very good at the back end of the financial part of it. And that's just what I do. That's my forte. And I'm good at that. I love all the paperwork. I love everything. I love all that. Right. I'm just very good at the research and all that. I'm very knowledgeable of that. But when it comes to the front of it, of the marketing and how to start and what to do, I'm stuck. And it had to be the hardest thing for me to sit there and be like, okay, AZ, I'm ready to learn. Mm-hmm. Because I was just like, oh, I'm just, yeah. That is the hardest thing. So do you ever find yourself bumping heads?
Oh, yeah. We bump heads. He's like, well, just let me know when you're ready. And I'm like, that makes me not want to be ready to talk to you. Just let me come to you when I'm ready.
Yeah.
I know you know stuff. Just let me get there.
AZ, and if I start to even argue with AZ or say something, he's like, are you going to listen or let me know when you're ready so I can come back and you can listen? I'm like, oh, when you do that, and then I don't want to ask you anything. So one of the things that another question I want to ask you is, I want to know, like, the challenges now that you have in the boutique going on, how are you transitioning everything you know, learned in the nursing aspect of it? You're really good with people.
Yeah.
You're really good with people. So what made you go into the boutique? And explain a little bit of your boutique. I'm saying boutique. It's not a clothing boutique. It's actually
a med spa.
Med spa.
Yeah, so we do med Botox spa. And fillers and, like, so you do, you know, Botox because you keep your frown lines away.
Oh, I like that. All right.
So you keep yourself young.
When I'm talking to you, am I not making any movement on my face?
You look good. You got to stay young.
This is a perfect, if you are interested in any type of Botox or fillers, right here. You got Caitlyn right here, right in front of you in our front door if you're interested. Yeah. Her husband's right around the corner in our office.
Yep.
But, you know, what's awesome is when Craig looks a little bit stressed out.
Well, he's just getting Botox tomorrow. Live.
There you are.
You're live on Facebook. It's 12:30.
So if you want to see her services, her gentle services with her own husband, watch him live on Facebook at 1:30.
12:30.
He's going to be on. That's awesome. Where is your store? Where's your boutique at?
It's on Lake Pleasant in Happy Valley. It's in a salon boutique, like a salon suite. So we have a little 150 square feet.
That's awesome. I can't wait to see for you to just blow up. I mean, I already know where you're going with this.
Well, my first idea was like much larger scale than med spa. And then as Rex came early and things happened, and then it was this opportunity to start small is what kind of hit. And I was like, all
right. Right here, high five. It's a small steps you took. You didn't stop. You were just like, I'm going to take a step back a little bit and take smaller steps, but I'm eventually going to get there. And that's how I know you.
Yeah.
I don't know you to stop. I just know you to say, okay, I'm going to take smaller steps versus, you know, bigger steps just because I need to slow down, but I'm not going to stop. So I love that. So you see yourself in a bigger salon,
so
obviously.
Like in like a year or so, I think we'll take on, you know, what I really wanted was like all the laser tech opportunities, estheticians, to have like a one-stop shop, but make it like the boutique or the salon suite rental stuff, to where you come to me, I have the space and you rent it. And not a lot of places have that because they offer an inclusive med spa, you know.
So if people want to reach out to you, are you going to announce that tomorrow? Let's announce it now. Where can people reach out to you if they're interested in some Botox or fillers?
So you can go on my Instagram at All Buttered Up Beauty.
Oh, I love it. Yeah. All Buttered Up. Up Beauty?
Yep, All Buttered Up Beauty.
Oh, I love it. I love that. And I'm so cute.
Because you got to be like a nice biscuit when you eat it. You're all buttered up.
That's funny.
So it's All Buttered Up Beauty on Instagram. And then I'm working on the Facebook page. And then I can send you the link for my Square website so you can see the prices.
Well, we got to get you in here. I know that we got to get you in here for a session. I'm going to open that up here at Asian Associates so you can come in here and start giving some, a big old
Botox party.
So I had to tell you, a lot of it, I've said this before, real estate will eat you and spit you out alive.
Yep.
So you got to, you got to keep up with
that. Well, you got to do it so you maintain the young, you know. It's a preventative action. It's not, it's not going to fix something. So if you got big deep lines, it's not going to fix
it. It's like one of those
today.
Moments when you don't want your clients to see your frustration. You know, in madness or, that frustrating.
Your face sells your business, so you want to be happy
fresh
looking.
You have no choice but to smile at your client when you really want to be frustrated. You're like, I can't move because all I can do is just smile. And you can totally make that happen, right?
Yeah.
It works. Well, that's awesome. Thank you so much for joining me. But before I get you off, I want to ask you, how do you see Craig's transformation since he's been here at Azian Associates? How do you see him as a father, a business owner, you know, as just as a friend, just an overall human being? How do you see him since he's been coming here?
So when he transitioned.
Since he's been here, transitioned.
He was a realtor for just about a year when he decided he was going to come to AZ. And the way he came to me.
I was going to tell the story. This is the funniest story Caitlyn told me.
He came to
What attracted him here a couple of years ago.
He came to me and he's like, babe, I'm going to this brokerage. Look at this guy's beard. And I'm like, what? That's not a reasonable. Like, what does he offer to you? What is it like? What is he doing? He's like, no. It's all about the beard. And I'm like, oh, God. This is going to go horribly wrong. And then he came for the interview and he came back to me with like what you guys would offer and how it was going to be better for us and like his business. And I was like, okay, so it's him coming here has been, even though it's based on AZ's beard, has been the best thing that's ever happened. And he's been here 4 years now, I think, or three. I don't know.
I believe it was four.
Yeah. So it's been, I've enjoyed it. I've gotten a lot out of it, learning and seeing such a strong couple in the business. Like you guys didn't always have it and you always share that with us. Like, so when I'm struggling, I always think, all right, you know what? They still are together and they still love each other and they still probably wanted to kill each other every now and again. So it's a good like role model because you guys are positive and upbeat to see. So it's helped both of us for him coming here
to see
such a good, strong core.
I absolutely love it. Thank you. Thank you for all those words. And it really is. I mean, we all face the same challenges in business, especially when you're working with your spouse. Or if you're not working with your spouse, but you're in the same household with a real estate agent, it's tough. It really is. There's a lot of high divorce rate, actually, in real estate. Because when you get into the game, you don't realize how much work you actually have to put into real estate as a business owner. Most people treat themselves, I'm an agent, but you're not. You're a business owner now, which means you got to go all in, not half in, all in if you want your real estate business to grow, extremely grow. A lot of things will be left behind if you don't learn to find that balance as well. So yeah, a lot of us here, we share a lot of our challenges and experiences and many challenges that we go through. I mean, it's an open door, you know, situation because we all go through the exact same thing. But thank you for joining me, Caitlyn. I truly, truly appreciate you. Oh, you are very welcome. I thought you would be the perfect fit for this because you're literally an all-rounded. I mean, you're nurse, business owner now, mom, wife. You're all these things. And you're always with a smile. That's what I love about you. You never say no. I have a fitness app, Do the Work, that I have available to the agents here at Azian Associates. And she was one of my models because she was pregnant. So I have a lot of videos of her doing some pregnant workouts. So, but you show up with a smile. You're like, I can barely bend over and squat, but I'm going to make this happen, Carla. I'm like, you just never say no. You're always just so cheery and happy. You have such a great energy, you and Craig. So I love you guys dearly, but thank you for joining me.
Thank you.
If you are interested in knowing more about Azian Associates, go to badassagents.com to apply and we'll reach out to you. Again, it's badassagents.com. If you want to know more about Azian Associates Real Estate Group, everyone have a great day and we'll see you on the next one. Bye.